When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? Darling, I will be loving you till we're 17.
Your mama looks so pretty.
Here we are together, and everything between us is good. I'm riding this cloud, babe.
Made me wanna start crying.
Ready to fly, but before I take another step, would you catch me if I fall? So used to being on my own, but this thing is new, babe. It feels like I'm losing control. I'll take another step. Would you catch me if I fall for you? 'Cause I fall. me fall? Would you do that for me? Hold me. Would you love? Will you love me? My
Not now.
Heart is ready.
Not now.
For love and to
Step
be
in.
Loved. And I choose you, baby. That's the one thing I'm sure of, so I will take this one last step. So catch me, I'm falling for you, 'cause
please remain standing while we go before the Lord in prayer. Would you bow your heads, please? Our most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the privileges of being in the body of Christ. We have come together to watch the miracle of your love and the power of your Spirit work in the lives of these two people. We give you the praise, the honor, and the glory for the power of the Holy Spirit in our lives to bring us into a place of union with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and union with one another. We thank you for it in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. You may be seated. These two persons would have chosen no other place to declare the love of their hearts for each other, for they both believed Jesus to be the Son of God and their Savior. Thus, Brandon and Brittany are already united in Christ as believers. They are bound together in love for Christ and his church. Now that that bond takes place on a new and beautiful dimension through the covenant of marriage, they believe their love for each other was initiated from above and is a gift from God. Because of their deep conviction that God has drawn them together for his divine purposes, we come with abundant joy to thank him for what he has done in their lives and to entrust their future to him. Who gives this bride in marriage? Amen. Brandon, would you step forth and take your bride? Turn this way, just turn straight to me. Straight to me. Straight to me. To the congregation, the audience, in the eyes of Almighty God, these two people are washed in the blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. They have prayed, and before the Lord God himself, they believe that it is the perfect will of God for them to be joined together in the Spirit. They have made their decision. So from now until the end of this age, I charge you to do everything in your power to see that this union remains solid and strong, happy and prosperous. Woe be to any person who would tamper with it and cause it to be anything other than prosperous in the eyes of God. And today, Brandon and Brittany have some words that they want to declare to each other at this time.
Oh. Brandon, they say that change is the only thing that is constant in this world. I can say that you have consistently showed me an unchanging love. You have been my best friend for over 8 years. And for over 8 years, I was... My bad, y'all. you have been my best friend for over 8 years. And for over 8 years, I was blind to the blessing in front of me. As many family and friends did not hesitate to tell me. I see now that God knew what he was doing. When I needed you as a friend, you were there. When I needed you as a spiritual provider, you were there. I thank God for allowing you to be everything I needed exactly when I needed it. And I vow to be everything you need and more.
Brittany. I love you more than words will allow me to express. You are the best friend I've ever had. And I truly thank God for allowing me to be in your life. Who would have known that the girl people call Kool-Aid that I crushed on in computer class in the 10th grade will one day become my bride and my wonderful mother, a wonderful mother of my daughter. Brittany, I vow to love you with every bone of my body. I give you my promise that this day forward, I will give you all of my love, and you shall not walk alone. I have no greater gift to give, as your love is my anchor and your trust. As your love is my anchor and your trust is my strength, you may my heart be your shelter and my arms be your home. From this day forward, we shall walk together side by side, never one in front of the other, while keeping God at the head of our lives. Brittany, I give you all that I am and all that I shall become. I love you, girl.
Amen, how beautiful. I mean, you can turn back. You can just stay right there. Amen, Brandon, would you join right hands together with Brittany? Okay. Turn to her and repeat after me, please. Brandon. Take thee, Brittany. To be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, to death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and there I give thee my pledge. Brittany, will you repeat after me to Brandon? I, Brittany, take thee, Brandon, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, to death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance, there do I give thee my pledge.
Amen.
May I have the rings, please? Just hold on a minute. From time immemorial, the rings has been caused to seal this most important of all human commitments. This ring is a beautiful symbol of your love. And in that, it is an unending cycle symbolizing the eternity of love and purity of your love in God's eyes in the marriage relationship. Brandon, may I have Brittany's ring? Will you take this beautiful ring as a meaningful token of your love for Brittany and place it on her left finger of her left hand. And repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed. With loyal love, I thee endow. All my worldly goods with thee I share. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Brittany, may I have Brandon's ring? This ring is a beautiful symbol and meaningful token of your love for Brandon. Will you now place it on the ring finger of his left hand, and while holding it, repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed. With loyal love, I thee endow. And all my worldly goods with thee I share. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Brandon and Brittany, on the basis of the covenant of love and by the authority given me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and in accordance with the laws of the state of Alabama, I now pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. You may kiss your bride. Amen. Brandon and Brittany have chosen to do a unity cross that they'll be able to keep, put on their mantle. So at this time, we're going to go over and they're going to build together the unity cross. At this time, Brandon and Brittany will assemble the Unity Cross, a beautiful sculpture they will display in their home to remind them of the covenant that they are making today. In Genesis chapter 1, we read that God created man in his own image. That means that he created man bold, strong, to be a leader, to be a protector of his wife and family. Brandon, take your part of the unity candle. And you hold it up. Don't take it, the outer form of the unity cross represents strength, leadership, and protection of the man. The book of Ephesians reminds us, husbands are to love your wives as Christ loved the church, totally and completely giving himself for her. Take your piece and hold it up. As well, Genesis 2, 20 through 23 tells us that the woman was taken from the man. The bride's piece of the unity candle cross represents the beauty and many qualifications and capabilities of the woman, designed with intricate, beautiful detail, and is placed inside the protection of the groom's cross, completing the sculpture and representing the two becoming one. At this time, Brittany, would you place your piece inside of Brandon's piece? Okay. These pegs represent the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, showing God's place in this covenant and the security and completeness that only the Heavenly Father can give. So you got the three plagues, Sam? This scripture tells us that a three-stranded cord is not easily broken. Exodus chapter 4, verse 12. Matthew 19, verses 5 and 6 says, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate." I would like to speak a blessing over your marriage. 1 Peter 3 and 7 says, "A man and his wife are heirs together of the grace of life. Remember, his grace will always be sufficient for you, and his strength will always be made perfect in any insufficiency you think you may have." So with God, you can get through everything that comes your way. Proverbs 18:22, one of my favorite, from the Message translation. Brandon, sir, the Bible says, "He who find a wife find a good thing and obtaineth the favor of the Lord." But the Message translation says, "Find a good spouse and you will find a good life forevermore." I believe you found a good spouse and you will have a good life. But you will also have the favor of God. So today, maybe may his favor shield always cover your marriage, and his blood covers you. God bless you both. So will you turn and face the audience, face the congregation, please turn. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Brandon Fitzgerald Garner. Woo, jump in the room.
Never met a man quite like you, doing all he can, making my dreams come true. You're strong and you're smart, you've taken my heart, and I give you the rest of me too. You're the perfect man for me. I love you, I do. Good about myself from my very first kiss. I'm here when you call. You've got it all and confidence like I never knew. You're the perfect man for me. I love you, I do. Oh my. love you, I do.
Girl, I still want you if you ain't alone.